speaking about witnesses for marriage ceremony for Chuppa, it is important to mention that the witnesses have to be kosher, that they need to qualify in order to witness the Khatan acquiring the Kala, the groom acquiring the bride. So what are the conditions for witnesses, for the Edim? First and foremost, they need to be Shabbat observant. They need to keep the mitzvot of the Torah, especially the lavim of the Torah. They should not transgress the negative commandments of the Torah, especially those negative commandments that are malchut, that have more punishment given by the court. So in order to make sure that the edim are kosher, one needs to make research to make sure that the edim qualify with all the qualifications that our sages teach us. And many times the edim, the witnesses, could be observant, but they might have some mistakes or shortcomings. So it is preferred that before the marriage ceremony, those witnesses make teshuvah, either to say khatati, abiti, upashati, right? To say that I repent, I sinned, I was negligent, or so forth, or whether to say the vidui, right? Asking forgiveness from Hashem, and after that they should witness the giving of the ring, right? The Edei Kiddushin. So this way they should not go into being a witness while they are considered non-qualified. So by repenting they would qualify themselves. So the Edim, another important thing is that the Edim should not be any person who has shortcomings of basar v'chalav. If they do not observe the halachot of kashrut, they cannot be a witness. If they do not observe Shabbat, they cannot be witness. If they do not observe other isurin of the Torah, they cannot be witness. Now, another important factor in choosing witnesses, kosher witnesses, for marriage ceremony is that the witnesses cannot be relatives, cannot be related to the khatan or kalla, to the bride or the groom, right? For example, the father of the khatan, the father of the groom, cannot become one of the witnesses. The grandfather of the groom cannot become the witness. Us, as well as the bride, cannot be the father, grandfather. Now, when it comes to the father of the grandfather, it's a machloket, it's an argument. There is an argument. And because there is argument among our hahamim, our sages, one should refrain from choosing his or her father of the grandfather as the witness. Now, one's brother cannot be a witness, right? One's in-laws cannot be a witness. Even if the witness is going to be future brother-in-law, that's not a kosher witness, right? One's cousin cannot be witness. Second cousin cannot be witness, right? One's son of the uncle cannot be witness, son of the uncle from the both sides, right? They cannot be the witnesses, right? So this is very important to make sure that the two kosher witnesses are both kosher. And if one of them is not kosher, the whole marriage ceremony becomes invalid. And the blessings that mentioned becomes invalid. And the marriage ceremony needs to be repeated. So one needs to pay extra attention in choosing the edim, the witnesses that they qualify. And those who misader are the misader kiddushin, they officiate the marriage ceremony, they need to be aware of these laws, making sure that the witnesses are qualified. Not under the chuppah, rather before the chuppah, they need to make sure, they need to ask to make sure who are the witnesses. And the witnesses need to see the groom, the chatan, giving the ring to the kala, to the bride. They need to witness that. So, seeing the ring given, it's very important. And if they don't see the ring given by chatan to the kala, by the groom to the bride, then the bracha of ring giving becomes bracha levatala, and the bracha needs to be repeated again, right? The bracha, the ring giving needs to be after the bracha. Just like the mitzvot that we do over last Yadan, that first we say the bracha and then we do the act. We say the bracha of shofar and then we blow in the shofar. We say the bracha of achilat matzah and then we eat matzah. Or many other examples. So it has to be after, the ring giving needs to be after the recitation of the bracha, of the blessing. Now, speaking about ring, it's very important that the ring must be a belonging of the groom, of the chatan. The chatan should have bought the ring, or if the ring is bought by the parents, the ring needs to be acquired by the groom. It needs to become his. The parents need to give it to him and he needs to acquire it. He needs to own it. Should be his. Which means, if for whatever reason, lo aleinu, if the chatan forgot to bring the ring from home and is under the chuppah, and everyone is waiting for the ring, right? The groom's mother cannot take out her ring and give it to her son. Here, go ahead, I lend this to you. Go ahead and use it for the ring ceremony. And after that, give it back to me. No. Or after that, buy me something. No, it has to be that if she's giving it to him, right, she cannot lend it to him. She cannot, the mother cannot lend it to the son, or anybody cannot be lent. It has to become his. They need to either give it away, forever becomes his, or he needs to buy it right there under the chuppah before giving it to the kala. Right? Now, speaking about ring, it's very important that ring needs to be simple. Very simple. It needs to be shave peruta. Right? That the witnesses would ask the chatan, is this ring yours? And they ask each other, is this shave peruta? Is this worth 5 cents? Right? it should not be expensive, because it makes a misconception, right, that it's a ring that is acquiring the wife, and it has to be expensive to acquire the wife. No, it could be as low as 5 cents, shabe peruta, whatever the peruta is these days, right? Peruta is a measure that we use in Judaism, right? So the Rav has to ask him if this ring is his. The ring should not be very fancy, as we mentioned. It should preferably be kesef, if I may add, because kesef is chesed, silver is chesed. The ring should be silver, right? According to Kabbalah, there is a lot of good things with silver. Not zahav. Zahav is gold, right? The letters of kesef, the numerical value goes up. The letters of zahav, the numerical value comes down. So it's better that it should be kesef, that there should be more shalom bayit, more beracha going up for the chatan mekalla. Now, if they couldn't, or if they preferred not to have silver, that's also fine. But silver is the preferred, as Harav Ben Yishchai Alav HaShalom mentions, right? Now, if the chatan forgot to show the ring, right, to the witnesses, that's okay. But the witnesses must see the chatan giving the ring to the kalla, the groom giving the ring to the bride. And it is very important that the future husband, the chatan, needs to say out loud, "Hare at megudeshet li betabat zug kedat Moshe Israel," that through this ring I am acquiring you, my wife, right? And he needs to emphasize, "I am acquiring." He needs to emphasize the word li. He needs to say it out loud, that I'm acquiring you for myself with this ring, when he says that pasuk, right? Needs to be out loud to the kalla. So Be'ezat Hashem, we should hear a lot of semachot among Am Yisrael, kosher weddings with kosher witnesses, ve'nomar amen.
אז